Proceed, Senator Tabitha.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I do rise, Mr. Speaker, to, of course, oppose this particular motion, Mr. Speaker. And one of the key reasons, Mr. Speaker, as to my opposing, is the fact that I've looked at the list of the 11 members, Mr. Speaker, and I just noted, as Senator Chimera has put it correctly, five of the members did not have an opportunity to vote last time. Four of the members voted for the impeachment of the governor, and two of the members saved the governor, Mr. Speaker. And actually, for the governor, this committee will not be very fair to her, and the only best fair would be the plenary for the governor, whereby everyone will have an opportunity to listen to the governor.
What is the point of order, Senator Mutenda?
Mr. Speaker, I don't like standing on this point of orders, Mr. Speaker, but it is under 101, Mr. Speaker. It is so wrong for a member of this House to cast aspersions on the integrity of the members of this House, Mr. Speaker. We cannot have names that are proposed in this list, and one senator stands and says that those members will not be fair to the process, to the governor, to the people of Meru, Mr. Speaker. The Senator Mutinda from Nairobi, or I don't know whether it's Nairobi or Kitui now, but Senator Mutinda must be called to order, Mr. Speaker, and she must withdraw that statement and apologize to the whole House for throwing that aspersion to the members of this committee.
Senator Mutinda, that point of order is sustained. You may have to proceed to withdraw that particular averment.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I withdraw and proceed stating that I believe that the plenary will be able to give our people of Meru more justice, more bigger hearing than the plenary way.
Senator, Senator Mutinda, you are still on the edge, and you risk going down the cliff. What you're saying is, are you saying the committee way cannot give justice to the people of Meru? Just proceed and conclude.
Yes, allow me to conclude and say and request that during the plenary session, Mr. Speaker, I would really request that colleagues will be in the House, we be able to maximize the allegations that have been presented before this House so that we can maximally be able to give the Meru people a fair hearing and also a final justice as far as this particular matter is concerned.
Order, Senator Fonande. May the Senator be heard in silence, please. Proceed, Senator Mutinda.
And lastly, Mr. Speaker, I just looked at the former governors and deputy governors who've been gone through impeachment, and most of them, apart from the governor of Embu, Governor Wambora, who appeared before this House twice, it's only Governor Kawira who seems to be making history in this House by appearing for the third time. And so plenary will be the fairest way for the people of Meru to be able to get justice and hope settle this matter once and for all. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Senator Rachel Murgo Julius. Senator Miraj.
Asante, Mstahiki Speaker, kwa kunipa fursa hii. Na mimi nasimama kuunga mkono ili kikao hiki kiwe cha maseneta wale 11 waliochaguliwa, kwa sababu wale ambao hawakuweza kuchaguliwa na wananchi wataweza kupata fursa ya kutoa kauli zao, kwa sababu tutakapoingia katika kuweza kukisikiza kikao hichi kwa pamoja, sisi kama wawakilishi ambao tumetumwa na vyama vya kisiasa hatupati fursa ya kupiga kura na sauti yetu huwa haisikiki. Kwa hakika watu wa Meru wamekuwa katika mtihani mkubwa, na ili masuala yao yasikizwe kwa ufasaha zaidi. Nasema hivi kwa sababu niliweza kukaa katika kikao kama hichi cha Siaya, gatuzi ya Siaya. Na kwa kweli tulipokuwa katika kamati ya watu 11 nilipata fursa nyingi sana za kuweza kuuliza maswali kwa undani. Mara ya mwisho tulipokuwa tumeketi hapa kwa pamoja kama kikao cha seneti na maseneta 67, niliweza kupata fursa moja tena ya madakika kidogo kuweza kuuliza swali katika mjadala uliokuwa unaendelea. Kwa hivyo mimi kama seneta wa Mombasa ningependekeza na kumuunga mkono seneta Sifuna ili tuweze kuachia majukumu haya wale 11 waliochaguliwa ili waweze kuenda kusikiliza kesi ya watu wa Meru na haki ipatikane. Asante.
Take your seat, honorable senators. We proceed to put the question. Honorable Senator Omtata Okoit, take your seat, please. Honorable senators, I will now proceed to put the question. That whereas, pursuant to Article 181 of the Constitution and Section 33 of the County Governments Act, on Thursday, the 8th of August 2024, the Meru County Assembly approved a motion to remove from office by impeachment Honorable Kawira Mwangaza, the Governor of Meru County. And further, whereas by a letter reference MCA/Rest/Volume 4/79, dated the 9th of August 2024, and received in the office of the Speaker of the Senate on Friday, 9th of August 2024, the Speaker of the Meru County Assembly informed the Speaker of the Senate of the approval of the motion by the County Assembly and further forwarded to the Speaker of the Senate documents in evidence of the proceedings of the Assembly. And whereas pursuant to Section 33, 3B of the County Governments Act and Standing Order 81B of the Senate by resolution may appoint a special committee comprising 11 of its members to investigate the matter. Now, therefore, pursuant to Section 33, 3B of the County Governments Act and Standing Order 81B, the Senate resolves to establish a special committee comprising the following senators. 1. Senator Wakili Hilary Sigei, MP. 2. Senator Abdul Haji, MP. 3. Senator Wahome Wamatinga, MP. Senator David Wafula, MP. Senator Gloria Oroba, MP. Senator Karen Nyamu, MP. Senator Boy Issa Juma, MP. Senator Eddie Okech, MP. Senator Shakila Abdallah, MP. Senator Beth Montet, MP. And Senator Beatrice Akinyi, MP. To investigate the proposed removal from office of the Governor of Meru County and pursuant to Standing Order 82 to report to the Senate within 10 days of its appointment on whether or not it finds the particulars of the allegations again as the Governor to have been substantiated. Will as many as of that opinion say aye?
Aye.
Will as many as of the contrary opinion say nay?
Nay.
The nays have it. Order, honorable senators, order. Order, order, order. Senator Mundegi, take your seat. Senator Fernandi, the motion is lost. What more do you want from that? No. Now, honorable senators, as you may have noticed, the majority leader moved the motion at order number 8 on today's order paper for the establishment of a special committee to investigate the proposed removal from office by impeachment of Honorable Kawira Mwangaza, the Governor of Meru County. The motion has been negatived. Honorable Senators, as I communicated earlier by way of a message, on the resolution of the Meru County Assembly made on Thursday, 8th of August 2024, for the removal from office by impeachment of Honorable Kawira Mwangaza, the Governor of Meru County, Section 33(3)(a) of the County Governments Act, and Standing Order 81(b) of the Senate, provide that the Senate may, by resolution, appoint a special committee comprising 11 of its members to investigate the matter or investigate the matter in plenary. The motion having been negatived, the route of a special committee is abandoned. And that now implies that the Senate will investigate the proposed move of